I had a request of Ron, one of my YouTube followers, to say some through an old book of whatever, and then especially an old electronics book. I don't know, there's always a problem, I don't know what period. For instance, we have here electronica of the 1970s, also electronica of the 1970s, and this is of the 1980s, etc., etc. So there's so much more to tell when we are, say, going through old books and old documents of the 1970s, 1960s, etc., etc. A German book, by the magazine, by the way, Funkschau, very, very important in those days, in the 1970s. But anyway, when you want to thumb through electronic circuits, go to this website. Thanks to Barry Blood, who told me about this website. You can find many, many, many documents, informations, schematics out of the 1960s, the 1990s, etc., etc. Good information there. And I have to say, I always find much inspiration there for my new videos, now 2021 anyway. This is a Dutch book called The Radio Book for Handel Amateur and Listener by Engineer Schiere. I want to thumb through it. It's a 1920s book, so approximately 100 years past. That makes it interesting. In those days, there was not so much knowledge about radio circuits. The only thing that they knew in those days was that there were electromagnetic waves on a certain frequency. In 1920, the first tube was more or less common, and here we have, for instance, many very interesting old things of the 1920s, 100 years ago. Wattmel gives the perfect mica capacitors, etc., etc. It's all Dutch, of course, anyway. The radio book. And, well, let's thumb through some very old circuits. At first, Mr. Vocht was an important person in the Netherlands in the 1920s. He made radio popular. He also established a radio and broadcast station that's even now in the 2021 still exists. As far as I know, it's the Avro. Here an old studio. You can see the curtains that had to damp all kinds of, say, high frequencies, etc., etc. Very old. Anyway, I hope I can finish this in approximately 15 minutes or so. Here a few important persons of the 1920s in radio and in the Netherlands. Again, another studio with a piano. Anyway, perhaps it's more interesting to Mr. Dubois, engineer, director of the Dutch Zijn Toestellenfabriek. Well, I cannot give now at the moment a quick explanation, but anyway, and I mean with explanation, an English translation. Dutch broadcasting or somewhat factory in Hilversum in the Netherlands. They made, of course, radios, and that's very important. This NSF in the Netherlands was important for the first radios that were made in the 1920s and sold to the public. And this is one of these radio circuits of the 1920s that were sold in those days. Here we have a schematic. Well, we have of course many schematics, but it's kind of problem to this is an old type amplifier. It's only an amplifier, so not specifically made for radios, with four tubes and a microphone. But I have to of course search for a typical radio circuit, not a transmitter circuit. The development of the radio by engineer Polak in the 1920s in the Netherlands, and radio reception. This is a very, very common way to show how radio reception works. This is the more or less common way about the electromagnetic spectrum. I have to thumb through very, very quickly. This is, for instance, perhaps interesting. The tuning capacitor in a radio coil has to have certain dimensions. And this was the so-called Dr. Nieper tuning capacitor. And you can see that the plates, capacitor plates, are, say, bound in a certain way, kind of, say, sharp edge. And that has everything to do with the linearity of a tuning capacitor. So with this tuning capacitor, they thought in those days that it could give a better spread of all the radio stations that were available in the 1920s, 1930s perhaps anyway, because this, say, way that this tuning capacitor acts is not linear. And other capacitors are also not linear, but anyway. Want to thumb through. Well, this is, I think, a very elementary and useful circuit with a triode tube. You can see here, there is the reception coil. There is a series capacitor in that reception coil. The signal, quite strange, but anyway, goes to the grid, and in between the anode and the minus, there is a, I'm absolutely sure, a high resistance earphone, and that's here. And HS means the high voltage, and of course AC positive and negative means the DC current that's flowing in that triode circuit. But this circuit is in a certain way very, very actual, because nowadays 2021, we can use in the same way a field effect transistor, and that field effect transistor has more or less the same properties compared to the triode tube. And this circuit is also in a certain way with the field effect transistor on my YouTube channel as a high frequency antenna circuit, antenna amplifier. I only have, 4 minutes to show more out of this old radio book of the 1920s. So I want to jump through to somewhat other circuits. These are some other circuits, and they are in fact also very interesting. Again, a triode tube. The current in the tube is set by the potentiometer, and here we have a not a series regulation, a series tuning, but a parallel tuning that's here. And this is also very, very usable in, say, modern times, 2021. 500 picofarad capacitor, the coil could be for medium waves or for short wave. The triode tube can be used, but on the other hand, you can also use a field effect transistor anyway. Very interesting. Also here, I can't give too much attention to this, but anyway, I only have 3 minutes, and here again, many, many interesting tube circuits. And important to tell that in these old tube circuits, there was often, and you can see that here, a back coupling coil. So this coil had to couple with that coil to make that the circuit has an extreme sensitivity on a certain frequency where they coupled and where the peak resonance was at its best. And this is a kind of failed circuit in a certain way, because only the distance between these two coils has an effect on the frequency, and often you see here a capacitor, tuning capacitor, with which you can tune in to that specific frequency, a radio frequency. 14 minutes, I only have 1 minute. So, let's look at this circuit. Well, again, the same issues and problems and whatever. They use a transformer here. There are also radio circuits where there is a resistance coupling between the first tube and the second tube. Now it is transistor coupling anyway. So let's finish with some beautiful old tuning capacitors. They are extremely beautiful, and I'm absolutely sure that nowadays, these 100 year later, they will surely work. and another tuning capacitor. Beautiful old capacitor. My camera runs out. Well, I can talk for hours about these old books, but now I have to stop. Hope you liked it. Thanks for watching.